Hi guys, yes, it's that time of year again. It's Star Wars Day. May the 4th be with you. And as usual, Lion THD has got a number of us Disney Infinity creators to put together some Star Wars adventures to show to you, and they're going to be uploaded throughout the day. And we have got some big hitters coming in there. We've got the Bowtie guy, his clip's already out there, so go and check him out now. Pupper H is in the house, Lion HT himself is doing it. We've got That Brown Bat, we've got Clinton, we've got Mighty 287, and we've even got Infinity Avengers himself uploading his own level, which I've actually seen, and it's amazing. So if you like Star Wars, this is the only place to be, because we've got some lovely adventures, and my adventure is built in a Star Destroyer factory. So I'm just going to go through this and show what I've been put together, but check out the clips, I'll put the link before, but this is my little adventure I've created for Star Wars Day. Now, when I saw that original opening sequence in Star Wars New Hope, it just blew my mind, and I've been a fan of Star Wars ever since. That iconic Star Destroyer ship chasing the Tantiv over Tatooine was just amazing, and I think everybody was just blown away. And it's one of the most iconic ships. I know the Millennium Falcon is well known, X-Wings and TIE Fighters, but if anyone sees the back end of a Star Destroyer, they all know it's Star Wars, and I just think it's just awesome. It's a bit like Apple logo, or it's like Coca-Cola symbol. As soon as you see it, you know exactly what it is, a certain brand. And that Star Destroyer ship there is absolutely brilliant. So for my toy box, I want to do something to basically celebrate the Star Destroyer. And I was thinking of different ways that Star Destroyers are used. And in the TV shows, I think it's in Andor as well, they'll show them decommissioning Star Destroyers in like these... They look like our ship docks, basically. So there's a little dock there while they have some maintenance crew working on it. So I thought, well, if I was building a Star Destroyer, I could have these like little docks where they're being built, or the opposite way, being decommissioned, and they would build the Star Destroyers, and when they're ready, they would lift up and launch the Star Destroyers. They're ready to go, and then get building the next section. And then you just get that iconic silhouette that is absolutely amazing. Love it. Look at that, that's so cool. So when I was building this toy box, I was trying to think, well, how do we use these docks? So I've got these like arms, these mechanical arms that come up, so I've created a tool that will make these arms go up and down. And then I thought, okay, well, nothing seemed to be happening here. Can these docks be more than just build a Star Destroyer? What if there was some sort of mechanic to them? There's a purpose to them. We have different docks for different things. So I was wondering then how I can then just increase the level. So you'll see there on the left, I've got some tall towers. And I thought, well, what if they're like fuel rigs? Yeah. So we've got little fuel rigs there. And I've got these little control panels that I haven't switched them on, because basically it just takes too long to go through them all. But what about these control panels that are able to refuel a certain ship? So I've now got the opposite way around. Instead of build a Star Destroyer to take off, what if a Star Destroyer comes in and comes in to be refueled, or comes in to get some upgrades? Yeah, so as it comes in, the arms automatically raise up to collect the Star Destroyer instead of just letting it disappear. And so I was basically trying to find different ways we could land a Star Destroyer. So then I came in, right, what I'm going to do is land a Star Destroyer, and I've come up with, kept on expanding and trying to beat the next level. And it jumps in. So I thought, well, while that's loading down, what we'll do is we'll switch this, and what we'll do now is we'll have the fuel pump come out and refuel the Star Destroyer. So in this particular scenario, this will come out and the Star Destroyer will be fixed. So then I thought, okay, so I've now got it refueling, right? What else can I do with the Star Destroyer? And my next idea, strangely enough, came from Clinton. He did, and it wasn't, he didn't do a level on Star Wars. He did a clockwork map, a castle with a big giant clock on it. It was a really genius map. You should go and check it out. It's brilliant. But he showed a circular, like, arm of a clock, and which then that gave me the idea of a crane. So he gave me this idea based on the clock level. So if you look at any of these other Disney creators, they'll all give you different ideas what to do. So I thought, right, well, taking that idea, I'm going to make it into a crane. So this is what I did, taking Clinton's idea from the arms of a clock, right? So I've got these little components here at the side, and you'll see I've tried to make them look like funnels. These little arm here, and this is on a crane based. Now, this crane, I thought, well, what if I have a Star Destroyer turn up in this dockyard that was damaged and it needed to be repaired? So what we could have is it could be on fire, but then I need to put the fire out. So I created this like water tower. And then I realized you could use these color tools so you can make the tools go blue. Yeah. And I have an idea when I do my, hopefully if I get time, I'm going to do a Revenge of the Fifth clip and how we change it not to be water, but to be oil. But I'll explain that later. So what we do here is we've got the water pumps all working. So just in case there's a damaged Star Destroyer, we can repair it. So I've got this crane coming out, and then I was trying to, what was I going to do with the crane? And I was trying to think with the cranes, how do I get the arms to move up and down? And because Disney Infinity is 10 years old, you have to try and work out how to bend the rules. Yeah, and I think that's one of its lasting appeals with me, is that, okay, we are limited to what we can do. But if you look at any of these creator clips, they try and bend the rules. They're doing clips on the latest TV shows that don't even, no one's creating these games, yeah? And it's just amazing. So just check them out, as I keep saying, keep looking through. But you'll see here, I've got Star Destroyer turning up. And the Star Destroyer is on fire, it's damaged. So I thought, okay, we'll get the Star Destroyer come down and the arms automatically come up. So I've already got the one in the back refueling. This one's damaged, this one's coming back in for repairs. And as you see, the arms come down, picks up the Star Destroyer, grabs it, it's all on fire. I hate having to plot them on a Star Destroyer, the fire things, but they're all on fire. So right, so now we've got the Star Destroyer, it's on fire. We need to put the fire out. So I thought, well, we've got to put it in water. And I thought, well, how do you get running water? So let's get the crane out first. So this is taken from Clinton's clock watch item that comes across. There's a pulls across, and it rotates around like a clock, yeah, like an arm. But these are the hoses to fire them in. So we're going to now jet this full of water, and I'm going, how do I get the water effect? So this is what I came up for running water. I thought it worked quite well. So we are limited to what we can do with this. So I put my little pump on, we've chosen the blue pumps, and the water starts flooding through. In comes the water, and it starts pouring into the Star Destroyer. Out the six pumps on the screen. And obviously we're in a container, so we start filling out, then the tank will start to fill up with water. By the way, there's 144 tiles there. Yeah, 144 tiles for that in one area. Yep. That's what they do to put these levels together, and then all the tubes will fall away. And you'll notice the fire's been put out, the steam just now clears away. We now have our Star Destroyer, the fire's been put out. I had a slight issue with the issue with it draining, but I thought I'll come back to that, I will work that out. But then I thought, well, I've got the Star Destroyer repair, I've got the Star Destroyer coming in for refueling. What else could I do with Star Destroyer? Well, it's meant to be a Star Destroyer factory. So I said, okay, well, I need to be building a Star Destroyer. And that wasn't as easy as I thought, because you're trying to build a Star Destroyer, I've got to have a half-complete Star Destroyer. There isn't a component for that. So this is my half-completed Star Destroyer, built up with a number of bricks. And to create this effect, I've got the bricks mapped to multiple paths. There's about 35 paths there, trying to put the shapes in different positions to give you that Star Destroyer template. But what I did is I put a Star Destroyer in its place, and then I used to trace the lines to get where the items are to map the items on the screen, and then I put little sparks on to scatter around to look like there's workers on it. So we've now got a Star Destroyer built. Yeah, so I then thought, right, so what else could we do? And then, you know, like a shipyard, when you've got like all the ships being on, I thought, I love these containers. I thought, well, what do we just have Star Destroyers lining? And if you look at the end of Attack of the Clones, you've got those Star Destroyers on the ground, and you see where they land. So I thought, well, what if we get a Star Destroyer to land on the ground instead? So not using the docking, so it uses a landing. So this is me getting an alternative way to Star Destroyer land. So Star Destroyer is coming in. Now it's going to drop off, and it's going to start up unloading various options. And again, these are different mechanics. I was trying to work out how to get them to work, and they all take up quite a lot of memory of these. And I've got an adventure planned with this level. My Revenge of the Fifth is where the five rebels basically blow this thing up. They're going to do a Michael Bay version. But there you go. There is my Star Destroyer with its feet. And again, we've got mixed shapes joined together to create like a type crow's type foot, which will look quite good. And now that the Star Destroyers land, the troop character is going to drive through, and the goods are going to be unloaded. The thing I would have done is I would have had containers coming out from that bottom, so it looks like they're on a tractor beam coming up and down. But the containers can't be linked to a path, so I was a bit stumped on there. So I just left the vehicle just driving up, and then it opens up its doors to get that sorted, which I was quite pleased with. And that's now unloaded and creating various things. And again, yes, we don't have many vehicles. So I have to make the best of what I've got. So Sandcrawler as a transport for Imperial thing was the best I could do. So we've now got our repairing Star Destroyer. Building Star Destroyer. We've got a Star Destroyer almost finished. We've got one that's been refueled and one been damaged. So then I thought, well, if we're going to have Star Destroyer, I'm going to have to do my favourite thing I love doing with Star Destroyer. There's nothing better than making a Star Destroyer crash. Yeah. And if you've seen my, which one was it? The Scarif one where them two collide together. Okay. How do I make a Star Destroyer different? And I'm working on a big battle. So I tried different things. I wanted to make it look like, how do you make it crash effectively? So again, this is just like a little bit of cheating. But I've got this Star Destroyer coming in, and it's all burst on flames. And it's coming through. And I just love doing this in Disney Infinity. There is nothing out here at the present moment that allows me to create my Star Wars, my own Star Wars adventures. It just does not exist. Not only that, I can do Star Wars, I can do Disney, I can do Marvel. There is nothing that allows me to create my own adventure, and I can still do it. Now, there's things I wish they still worked or they'd done another version. If they had done another version, it just kept on getting better. But here's the Star Destroyer coming in. Oh, he's just managed to pull it up in time. Nope. Oh, no, it looks like he's in trouble. That is going to be very, very close. Ooh, going to just miss my head. All right, so we've got some fire turn around. So we just turn around, and then we've got the Star Destroyer crashing into the ground. And I've done a bit of trick camera work here. So I've got it to look like it's ploughing through the land. So the only way I can make that work, because it's really difficult, is not show you that land until it's too late. And then I've got a couple of bits and pieces on here. Now I've been playing around with this effect, and I've run out of memory. So I can make this crash look even better. So I've got a few more ideas on making this crash work, because those pieces should be moving as well. So when it crashes into the ground, they should be rolling forward, but at a slower pace. But that is my toy box adventure. I hope you liked it. I hope you liked some of the mechanics in there that I used, trying to do different things with it. I'm going to extend doing my story with this, which is the Revenge of the Fifth, where we try and do, like I say, Michael Bay, where we blow everything up. Go look at my list. I'll do links to all the other creators. Lion HT has been organizing it. We've got nearly 30 creators in there, so go check everybody out. There's some really cool events. Now, have a great Star Wars day. I'm now off to watch a Star Wars film, which I do every May the 4th. I'm not too sure which one I'm going to watch this time. I think I'm going to go for Episode 1. I want to see the pod race. Well, look, have a great Star Wars day, guys, and I will catch you soon. Catch you later. Bye.